as we always do, with the gossip of Grinder Switch herself. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Southern Illinois Opera stage, Miss Minnie Pearl.
All tonight. You all look so pretty. Before I come out here, I asked my feller Hezzy, I said, how do I look? And he says, Minnie, as old as you are, I can't believe you're still trying to attract the fellers. And I said, well, I've been told I have the face of a 16-year-old. And he said, well, you better give it back. You're going to have it so beat up she won't want it back. He did. He said, he also said, Minnie, there ain't nothing better than a pretty girl, and you're better than nothing. He did. He's my fellow guest. I'll tell you what, I'm all the time looking for some beauty secrets. I am trying to stay young. And you know what? You know what happens to a gal that don't know the difference between cold cream and putty? All her windows fall out. Anyway, I'm all the time looking for beauty secrets, and I heard if you took a bath in milk, it'd make your skin all smooth and soft and young looking. So I told that old milkman, I said, I want you to bring me 50 gallons of milk. And he said, you want that milk pasteurized? And I said, no, just up to my neck. Everybody's going on little vacations, and we went on a little vacation. We did, me and Mammy and Uncle Nabob and Aunt Ambrosie. We all went out west. Oh, we had such a good time, I never will forget it. We was out west in this little western town and walking around, and we lost Aunt Ambrosie. So we was looking for Aunt Ambrosie, and we come upon this friendly old Indian just standing there, and Uncle Nabob went up and said, we seem to have lost a little lady. Have you seen a little lady wandering around? And the Indian said, ugh. And Uncle Nabob said, yeah, that's her. Which way'd she go? Well, now, Uncle Nabob and Aunt Ambrosie, they go on trips right often. They do. Why, just last year, they went on a trip with old Zeke Jones and his wife. And the first night at the motel, Uncle Nabob said to Zeke, hey, let's do like the young folks do and swap partners. Well, that night about 12 o'clock, Uncle Nabob said to old Zeke, he said, I wonder how the girls are doing in the other room. Oh, I'll tell you. Anyway, brother, he went on a trip. He went up to the big city. Now, you heard me talk about brother, haven't you? Brother's just a little slow-witted. In fact, we took him to town the other day, and everybody was pointing at him and running. And finally someone said, what's the matter with him? He got the chicken pox or what? And I said, oh no, we're just learning him how to eat with a fork. But anyway, brother, he goes up to the big city, and he stayed in this big, fancy hotel. Oh, it's so big and fancy and pretty. And when he goes in, the desk clerk had him sign the registrar book. Well, now, brother can't read and write, so he just made his X in the registrar book. And about that time, a real pretty girl went walking by, and that desk clerk poked brother and said, see that real pretty girl? I can introduce you. And so brother turns around and draws a circle around his X. And the desk clerk said, well, what'd you do that for? And brother says, well, if you think I'm going to do things like that, you don't expect me to sign my right name, do you? Oh, well, brother decided the next morning to get up and go see the sights of the city. So he went down to the bus stop, and there's a big, long line, and it wasn't moving. And he noticed at the front of the line there was a real shapely young woman standing there trying to get on the bus. She had her arm full of packages, and her skirt was just a little too tight. So every time she tried to get up on that step, she couldn't get up on that step. Well, the crowd was getting so aggravated, they started pushing up on her. So she was crammed up there, trying to get up on that step, and And very discreetly, she reached back and unzipped her skirt just a little bit, thinking it'd give her more room. And it didn't. So she reached back there and unzipped her zipper just a little bit more. And about that time, the fella behind her picked her up and plopped her on the bus. Why, she was horrified. And she turned around to him and she said, "I cannot believe you done that." She said, "Why, I don't even know you." And he smiled and tipped his hat and said, "Well, ma'am, the second time you pulled my zipper down, I figured we were right close friends."
Help me. We're going to give away 3 sets of tickets to future shows. So here we go. All right, where is Kay Huff? Okay, all right, you've got yourself a pair of tickets. Next set of tickets goes to Julie Hutchison.
Hey!
Julie, you've got yourself a pair of tickets. Pick these up right after the show.
All right.
And